The main thing that drew me to Southampton was the knock. I looked around it with my mum and it was just, it's a beautiful campus. I just could see myself studying there. The facilities were just amazing. We did sort of test practicals and that kind of thing and it was just great. I just really enjoyed the atmosphere and the space. It's quite a small community, so only the sort of earth sciences study there. The library's beautiful, it's over three floors. Because it's quite a small community, you get to know everyone that you pass every day. The cafe's great, the food's amazing. It's nice to feel comfortable in a place because you recognise people, it's not unfamiliar. You know that there's research going on, if someone's found something exciting, the buzz goes around the lecturers and then one of them will put it in a lecture and that's it, the students know as well. Geology is kind of predominantly earth sciences. It's a very wide-ranging subject, you study from volcanoes to earthquakes to oil to environmental issues such as, nuclear waste and disposal and that kind of thing. So it's really, geology encompasses a very wide range of earth science aspects, looking at, the physical earth around you. Throughout a geology degree, fieldwork is an essential part, because how can you study the world around you without looking at it? If a trip is compulsory, so on a core module, it will be funded by the university, you just have to buy your own food. And then in your first year, the trips you go on really teach you the basics of geological fieldwork, whether it's mapping or just general observation and analysis of rocks, what kind of things you're, as a geologist, you should be looking out for that gives you the clues to what's going on around you. And then as you progress through your degree, you get to go on more and more exciting trips. So my favourite trip was the Tenerife trip, which you take in third year as part of a volcanics module. And you spend the week looking at all kinds of volcanic deposits. My dream job would be an outreach volcanology worker. You can study so much with geology. Lots of people, obviously, when you think geology, lots of people think oil industry, but it covers environmental jobs as well. I know people that have gone into looking at cleaning up nuclear waste and other environmental problems. People go into renewable energy, looking at if you've got to drill down into bedrock to put a wind turbine in, then you need a geologist. There's also lots of engineering geology jobs. Things like cutting, if you're trying to cut a road through a hillside, you need a geologist there. If you're trying to dig a tunnel, a geologist will be there. And then there's obviously the kind of seismology and looking at earthquakes and volcano monitoring and that kind of thing.